Hello again and welcome to our GCP Mindset channel. My name's Carol, and today with the help of our biostatistics team, we thought we would simplify the different types of clinical studies and designs you may come across when running clinical studies. This is not an easy topic, as for each study design classification, there are different dimensions to the classification. Therefore, the types of designs should be assessed on a case-by-case basis. More after the break. Every clinical study will have a protocol or action plan for conducting the clinical trial. This plan should describe everything about the study, such as the type of patients who can enter the trial, the schedule of tests and procedures, including the dosage, the necessary follow-ups, and the length of the study. It also describes the results or endpoints that will be measured and the type of information to collect. Once a manufacturer of a product, whether it's a device or a drug innovator, has identified what they would like to show, for example, the safety and performance of a medical device, or that a certain drug is great at treating patients, then a clinical study plan is drafted with the help of medical experts, biostatisticians, and the sponsor. Together, they plan the design of the study based on what the study is supposed to prove. That means it's objective. The objective is also the starting point for the biostatisticians to determine the sample size. That means the number of patients required to conduct the study. If there are too many patients required based on the objective, at times, this can also lead to adjusting the study design or even the objectives of the study. Well-designed studies are critical to successful clinical development of drugs and devices that can reach the market and help the patients. The biostatistician's aim is to design a study that supports deriving a valid and meaningful scientific conclusion using appropriate statistical methods, and through this creating robust and reliable evidence for safety and performance or efficacy. These conclusions are important as they have an impact on whether the drug or device are allowed to enter the market or the clinical development can continue. Convincing evidence is required, and if the study design does not support drawing meaningful conclusions, then the study might even have to be repeated. There are different types of study designs, and we will simplify the different study designs for you. Overall, we have two main groups of studies, one observational or non-experimental study, where we observe both exposures and outcomes without trying to change who is or who isn't exposed to it, and two, experimental studies, where we introduce an intervention and study the effects or the outcome. Let's start with observational studies. These are studies that observe the effect of a risk factor or treatment or other intervention without trying to manipulate them to see effects. We have different types of observation studies. These are one, case reports. These provide an opportunity for the investigator to describe the observations that make a case unique. Two, ecological studies. These provide a description of population group characteristics. Three, cross-sectional studies. These studies observe a population at a specific time point as opposed to observing patients for a certain duration of time. Four, case control studies. These are used to compare two groups, such as subjects with and without disease, to look for differences in risk factors. And lastly, five, cohort studies. These look at patients that share specific criteria such as age or place of residence or the doctor. We'll leave it here today and talk about the second group of studies next time. We hope this was helpful. Remember, this was mainly a guide to understand the basic concept of classifying the different study designs. For more on this topic, you can check out our Biostat series also found here or contact an expert. Until next time, goodbye.